Imagine your favorite constellation without one of its brightest stars. For a brief moment, this may happen to Orion. Astronomers are excited that an asteroid is heading for Betelgeuse. So the occultation will definitely happen. The question is, who can observe it? The Betelgeuse event was a hot topic last September in Armagh, Northern Ireland, at the annual European Symposium for Occultation Projects. Organized by the International Occultation Timing Association's European section, amateur astronomers and professionals discussed how to observe and exploit this rare opportunity. An occultation of a first magnitude star is rare. Such an event is visible from Earth only every few decades, but watching one can give astronomers valuable scientific information. By precisely timing the duration of the occultation from many sites simultaneously, they can refine their knowledge of the size and shape of the asteroid. They may even be able to map Betelgeuse's strangely large convective cells, by which the star brightens and darkens for months at a time. Betelgeuse is the 10th brightest star in our skies, plus 0.5 magnitude, so observers need only modest equipment to participate. If Betelgeuse appears larger than Leona, the occultation will end up resembling an annular solar eclipse. The star won't be completely blocked even at the center line of the shadow's path. If it's more on the smaller side though, and the Leona shape model proves to be correct, there will be a narrow strip of totality, a few kilometers wide around the center line, where the star completely disappears for something between 5 and 15 seconds. Leona itself will only be visible in large telescopes, as its brightness is 14.3 mag. The farther you are from the center line, the lesser the magnitude drop you'll see. The asteroid 319 Leona will pass in front of Betelgeuse, briefly blocking its light. That could be a fun thing to witness, something that will be possible without a telescope, but the details on how it happens could prove very scientifically revealing. If predictions are correct, Betelgeuse will disappear only inside a narrow corridor stretching from Central Asia and Southern Europe to Mexico and Florida. On December 12, 2023 at about 109 to 127 Universal Time, Leona will occult Betelgeuse as seen from Southern Europe, Turkey, Greece and Sicily. The 14th magnitude asteroid will occult Betelgeuse, block or reduce the light, for about 12 seconds. Betelgeuse is expected to dim by about 3 magnitudes. Observations of other occultations by 319 Leona in September 2023 showed the asteroid is slightly elliptical and enabled the construction of a preliminary 3D model of Leona. The model also confirms its size to be about 80 by 55 kilometers, and it is believed Leona will have a silhouette of about 46 by 41 milliarcseconds. Betelgeuse has an apparent size in the sky of about 40 mas, but its diffuse atmosphere may make it appear around 50 mas in size. If Betelgeuse appears larger than Leona, its light won't be completely blocked, but if not, there will be a narrow strip of totality, a few kilometers wide around the center line, where the star completely disappears for something between 5 and 15 seconds. Betelgeuse is no ordinary star. As well as being the 10th brightest in our sky on average, it has the second largest angular diameter if you don't count the Sun. As a very evolved star, it's probably our best chance to get a front row seat at a supernova, although debate continues as to whether that's decades or almost 100,000 years away. Uncertainty like that makes any information we can learn about Betelgeuse uniquely valuable. Nevertheless, when we can't see it seems like an odd time to get the best information. It's not as though anyone tries to study Betelgeuse during the day or on cloudy nights. Nevertheless, many astronomers consider the timing excellent. Known as an occultation, the passage will mean that an observer in the right place will see about 94% of Betelgeuse's light blocked, briefly reducing it to the status of a very ordinary star. 319 Leona, provisional designation A920 He, is a dark asteroid and tumbling slow rotator from the outermost regions of the asteroid belt, approximately 70 kilometers in diameter. It was discovered on October 8, 1891, by French astronomer Auguste Charlevoix at Nice Observatory in southeastern France. Leona orbits the Sun in the outer main belt at a distance of 2.7 to 4.1 astronomical units once every 6 years and 3 months, 2,295 days. Its orbit has an eccentricity of 0.22 and an inclination of 11 degrees with respect to the ecliptic. Prior to the realization of where its path was taken, 319 Leona was not considered a particularly interesting asteroid. It's 70 kilometers, 40 miles, across, bigger than most we know, but hardly a giant, and orbits towards the outer part of the main asteroid belt. Leona is dark and reddish in color and is considered a P-type asteroid that rotates slowly, taking around 18 days to turn around. Among the many thousands of named minor planets, Leona is one of 120 asteroids for which no official naming citation has been published. All of these low-numbered asteroids have numbers between 164 EVA and 1514 RICO and were discovered between 1876 and the 1930s, predominantly by astronomers Auguste Charlevoix, Johann Palisa, Max Wolf and Carl Rienmuth. On December 12, dark asteroid 319 Leona will pass directly in front of Betelgeuse, allowing observers to make a crude map of the giant star's surface. That means that in the 17 minutes the occultation will be visible somewhere, Leona's rotation won't be much of a factor. The occultation path starts in eastern China, then crosses Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Azerbaijan, Armenia, Turkey, Greece, Italy, Spain, Portugal, the southern tip of Florida, US, and finally ends in Mexico. Light curve studies of the event may help understand the distribution of brightness over the disk of Betelgeuse. As Leona moves across the stellar disk, it will pass over large convection cells on the surface of Betelgeuse, which are brighter than the average of the surface. Brightness measurements therefore could provide information on the distribution of these cells.